We're going to be talking about the next step, and that's the step that it's also just like the previous one we took emanates from the first. You understand? Likewise, this one also emanates from the last one also, because after when you are in the process of creating a profile, you need to update that profile. Do you understand? You need to update your Canadian immigration profile, and in the criteria and the requirements for the filling of the profile, the things that you need to put apart from the language test is your experience. Now, when I'm talking about experience, a lot of people may think that you are going to be making use of just writings. You know, when we are writing our CVs, our curriculum vitae, we always just write the number of experience, what we worked, you understand, the positions. Even though those things are added, you need to write your roles and responsibilities in your Canadian immigration profile. You need to write the years or the months that you worked. You need to write the type of work that you did, if it is full-time or part-time or contract staff or things like that. But apart from all those, you are not just going to write. You are also going to show an evidence that you worked that particular amount of time, or you worked in that location, you worked in that business, in that enterprise, for the amount of times that you actually purported while filling the form. But how will you show your experience? How would you let them know that it is that what it is, all what you said in the form or in the profile that you actually did? How you do that is through what we call the experience letter. And some people may call it another thing. They may call it the reference letter. You understand? The job reference letter. Now, that letter, you are going to collect it from your employer. Do you understand? Your employer, maybe perhaps you worked in, how would I call it? You worked in a school, for instance. You understand? You work for, maybe, for instance, let me take those that are actually doing their youth course service. For people working on their youth service, you can also make use of, that's one thing that you must also take note of. You can also make use of the year of experience that you got. That's just 1 year of experience you got from your youth service for application to Canada. It is also looked upon as a job experience. You understand? So you don't need to actually remove it, because some people during their applications, they may want to remove it that it is a government work. You were paid for it. And the concept of Canadian immigration work experience is that any work that you were paid for is what you should actually put there. Anything that you were just applying for, maybe voluntarily, that doesn't require you to get paid for it or doesn't have a stipulated time, you understand? Maybe it's not a full-time job or a part-time job, you can't put it. But since you were paid for it and it's a full-time, because yes, the youth service work that you do is considered as a full-time work, even though some people may not finally serve fully for the whole month or years, for the whole month or days or weeks. That the main thing is we recognize it as a full-time job. So just 1 year of service can also help you a great deal in your work experience. So as I was saying, as you are feeling it, you must go back to meet your employer. Maybe the school that you work, for instance, you must go to meet the principal. Maybe it's the company that you work, you go to meet the director. Maybe it's a non-profit organization, you go meet the manager, you understand? Or maybe it's in a multinational company, you can meet the HR, you understand? The HR department, the human personnel department. You tell them that you are working on your Canadian immigration and you would like them to help you draft out a job reference letter. And what will be in the job reference letter? What will be in the job reference letter is the amount of monies that they gave you in terms of salaries or wages when you were actually working in that organization. You must put the amount of hours you worked. For full-time jobs last for 1560 hours if we are to calculate 40 hours per week. You understand? So that means for a whole year you worked 1560 hours. You must write that down, or they must write it down, that that's the amount of time that you actually worked in their organization. And if perhaps it's a part-time for perhaps maybe you worked part-time job for 2 years. If you calculate the 2 years, it will all sum up to 1560 hours. You understand? So that will be looked at just 1 year of full-time job in the Canadian immigration, you understand, office. Now, another thing you must note when you are getting your job reference letter is that they must write the duties, the responsibilities, the roles that you performed in that organization clearly, and it must be very much close to what you are trying to do or what you are, the kind of job you are trying to get in Canada. It must be related to what we call an NOC, which is the National Occupational Classification that they make use of in the Canadian immigration. It must be very close to things that are in that NOC. Now, if you have any question based on the NOC, you can go to cic.gc.ca, which is the Canadian immigration website, to check the NOC classification or the section that talks about the job bank. And if you have any questions that you'd like to ask me about the job reference letter, you can also contact me on our website. The contact list on our website, aosacademy.com/contact, or you can call me personally on +234 810771 4449. And before I leave you, I would like to tell you that your reference letter too must also have a date attached to it. You can't just write a letter without putting a date, without putting it in the letterhead, on the letterhead of the organization. It's very, very important. After you put a date, the date must not be more than 6 months from the day you submit it for the Canadian immigration people. You understand, the Canadian immigration office. It must be not more than 6 months before you actually submit it, so that they can actually track it. Because any contact you give, the contact of the person that you got the letter from must also be added to the reference letter, because they would also contact the person to see if truthfully you worked in that organization. Truth pays, as I said, so you always make sure you don't lie about it. Go to the organization and try as much as possible to get the accurate information about what you did over there. So thank you very much, and I hope to see you in the next video.